tonight's starting lineups. First, as we welcome and introduce the visiting Dolphin student, University Huskies. Introducing first at guard, 6'9", sophomore Chad Hanson, Minnesota, number 33, Zach Stone. At forward, 6'6", sophomore Stowe, Ohio, number 4, David Walker. At guard, 6'2", junior, Virginia Beach, Virginia, number 2, Demetrius Butler. At guard, 6'1", junior, Boston, Massachusetts, number 11, Marco Benegas Flores. And at forward, 6'8", junior, Hershey, Pennsylvania, number 43, Scott Etherington. Coaching staff, Northeastern University, coordinator of basketball and basketball, Scott Murphy, assistant coach, and joining with the college team, Ryan McDonald, associate head coach, David McLaughlin. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this 8th season at Northeastern University, the head coach, Bill Cohen.
White numbers, red letters, and red trim. Northeastern will go right to left to start. Delaware left to right. Devon Saddler got to the 2,000-point mark last game. Now he's got Mike Pegues in his sights, 21 points away from becoming Delaware's all-time leading scorer. Mike Pegues currently on top with 2,030 career points. Pegues, of course, a legend, played from 1996 to 2000, but Devon doesn't want that scoring title as much as he wants what Mike Pegues had, which was a trip to the NCAA tournament. Right now, Delaware playing for that, and they're playing very well to start the year, 8-0 in the CAA.
Had an opportunity to watch Mike Pegues play a number of times. A player from St. Mark's, John Gordon, played with him. Pegues was so masterful down on the low block, and I think Carl Baptiste has begun to be that kind of player. Pegues was very active in his post-ups. Carl has 3, maybe even 4 inches on him height-wise. Mike's ability to play in the post was because he was so smart. He used his body, he used ball fakes, and had a variety of moves. And I think that's what we're beginning to see, an evolution of Carl Baptiste's game into more than just a power player, a finesse player.
Baptiste Etherington will jump it off. Baptiste wins it. And I'm looking forward to that matchup. Baptiste Etherington, round 2 here in Newark. Delaware has the basketball first. They go to Usher on the right side. Pinkert on top. What a game he had on Saturday. 3 of 3 from triple. Usher turns, fires from 10. Front rim, no. And Etherington grabs his first board.
Northeastern will play a variety of defenses. That was man-to-man, but they will employ a lot of 3-2 zone, which they played exclusively against Towson.
Stahl on top. One dribble and a handoff to Walker. Walker playing very well as of late. Stahl open. Extra pass in the corner. Back to Stahl, 17 to shoot, first possession for Northeastern, tie score at zeros. Inside stall, lost grip of it, out of bounds, and a turnover for Northeastern. This was a very clean game up in Boston between these two teams. Just 6 turnovers for Delaware, 4 for Northeastern, but the first so far.
And that's a very low turnover rate for Northeastern. They've been averaging 14 throughout the season. That's been one of their big problems, and why they're not able to score as high as a team like Delaware, who takes much better care of the basketball. That was a terrifically delivered pass by Marco Flores to Stahl, who just took his eyes off it instead of following it all the way into the catch.
See, Flores starting this game, he played just 3 minutes against Delaware on the 18th, did not score, but he starts a lot. Doesn't do much in the stat line, but he's out there getting some good minutes over the last couple of games for the Huskies.
And this is a small team that Northeastern's employing here. They're really playing with 4 guards, and Etherton inside is the only big.
And there's a stoppage on the floor because the shot clock, they're trying to reset it back to 35. There's been a lot of problems with the clock and the scoreboard over the past, I would say, week or so.
Remember when we were up at Matthews Arena that they had to actually bring out a shot clock from some archive,
that's
I believe.
Right. Yeah. I was surprised it wasn't a guy flipping red and blue.
Now, Scott, you're dating me. That's the way we used to do it when I was playing.
They got it, though, to 35. 19-11. We're just underway here at the Bob Carpenter Center. Each team has had a possession. Neither team has scored. Anderson's first touch in the corner. Dribbles back to Saddler. Saddler will run the offense from the center circle. Over to the left side. Mid-left block is Baptiste, guarded by Etherton. Baptiste to the rim, baseline, shot blocked by Etherton. Out of bounds, will stay with Delaware, 12 to shoot on the inbound.
And as a big, you should never worry about getting your shot blocked. Most times, it's blocked out of bounds. Delaware retains possession. I love the fact Baptiste was attacking Etherton right from the get-go.
Lobbing, Pinkert. Jumps over his defender, Pollard, and it's back to Saddler. He's got 7 to work with near half court. Inside-out dribble, blows past Walker. Over his head, can't get the roll, but he was grabbed hard. I don't even know how he got the shot off. Some creativity. He'll shoot 2.
He gets that shot off because he is so strong. He has a football-type body. He's able to get down to the lane with one big step after a pound dribble. And I thought he did a great job of trying to attack Etherton, who then backed away, and the foul was on Walker, I believe. And that's another key to the game. If Saddler can get Walker in trouble, that's going to be a big problem for Northeastern with that short bench.
It was on Walker, his first, Northeastern's first. Bill mentioned the short bench. Reggie Spencer not playing today. Quincy Ford already injured, and Saddler makes the first 2. Nearly a strip on the full court pressure. It'll stay with Northeastern as it goes out of bounds. Good D by Anderson and Pinkert.
Delaware has been utilizing this full court 1-2-1-1 half court, sometimes 3-quarter, sometimes full court press, and they had a big steal the other afternoon against UNC Wilmington to key the comeback.
A lot of great defensive plays keyed that comeback. Stahl loses footing and travels with it. Second turnover for Northeastern in 3 possession.
Most teams utilize the press coming out of a timeout, maybe the start of the second half, but Delaware here has opened the game up with it. A little unusual for Delaware, and I think that may have caught Northeastern off balance.
And we'll see some substitutions. Zach Stahl going to check out. We'll see Jimmy Marshall check in. Also, Flores checks out, and we do see Reggie Spencer. Reggie Spencer has not played the last 3 games since the Delaware contest, which he scored 8 points in, and now he's getting some action. Baseline spin, Usher into traffic. Spencer might have got a block on the play. Baptiste the rebound, and he gets a power dribble up strong again, and Baptiste has 2 for Delaware.
And that time, Carl Baptiste used the dribble to regain his balance and gather himself in a very smart play inside, a very aggressive offensive rebound position.
2 minutes in, Delaware leads it 4-0. Spencer's first touch on offense, and he goes to Walker. Reposting is Spencer. They don't go to him. At the foul line, Etherton around and out. Rebound by Devon Saddler. Saddler pushing quickly across half court, inside the arc, gives it back to Usher. Usher to Pinkert, squares, wing 3, around and in. Devon Pinkert's made his last 4 triples, going back to Saturday.
Great start by Delaware, reversing the court with Devon Usher's dribble, and then to a wide open Pinkert, who's got a very quick release on his triple.
It's 7-0 Delaware to start this one. And the rookie Pinkert playing well. Going back to Saturday against UNCW when he had some big shots. Etherton takes it to the rim. Can't find the angle he likes. Misses using the left hand. And a whistle as it goes out of bounds with 17-12 remaining.
Etherton took a mid-range shot on the last possession, which is what he did up at Northeastern. And from now on, you'll see him shot fake and try to get into the lane.
10 seconds on the inbound. They go to Etherton. Right block, double team comes. Can't stop Etherton off the window and through. Plus one for the transfer from St. Francis.
Low out of bounds play. They worked on that play yesterday. Carl Baptiste a little slow to cut off Etherton as he came from the opposite block and got a great pass and finished with the ball off the backboard. Carl Baptiste got to be a little bit more adept at recognizing what play's being run.
Etherton makes the free throw. First foul on Carl Baptiste. First on Delaware. And it's 7-3, 3 minutes in. Delaware has the lead. Saddler going to run the offense. Right side it goes to Usher. Delaware passing beyond the arc. Anderson extra pass, Saddler. Saddler driving baseline into Spencer. Can't get it to go. Pinkard tips it, and back to Northeastern it goes.
Delaware drove the ball. That was a 3-2 zone employed by Northeastern. We thought we'd see a little bit of that. Saddler right at the rim. Good move by him.
Jimmy Marshall thought about the three instead, gets it to Walker. Spencer still posting up. Pollard thought about the entry pass. Didn't go. Saddler working hard on him. Pollard lets it fly way off the mark, maybe deflected by Usher, but another rebound for Saddler as he pushes.
A great contest by Usher there to close out Pollard, a terrific three-point shooter.
Saddler over to Pinkard on the wing, left side this time. Spins, drives, kicks out Usher, good luck by Pinkard, and Usher finishes from beyond the arc, ends up 10-3.
Pinkard returning the favor, dribbling through the lane, a great gap attack, found Usher spotted up on the left side.
53rd three on the season for Devon Usher. Now Spencer from the elbow left misses, and Usher a rebound. Saddler wants to go to the top of the key. Inside to Baptiste. Baptiste, good plus one. And Delaware's off to a 12-3 start. Carl Baptiste will shoot a free throw when we come back. 15:42 to play in the first half. You're listening to 94.7 WDSD.
Carl Baptiste is open down the lane. He does it in two ways. He drag dribbles the defender who's on Baptiste and allows Carl to immediately slip the screen, or he picks it up right away and throws a quick air pass to Baptiste as he rolls down the lane. One thing about Northeastern, they do not do a great job of helping in the lane, and especially Scott Etherton. If he is off and not guarding Baptiste, he's slow to rotate. He does not want to get in foul trouble.
Baptiste at the free throw line. Finishes the three-point play, and Delaware up 10 early, 13-3, and we'll see full court pressure by the Hens. Walker leaves his feet to break it, and he gets it to Derek Opec, who didn't play against Delaware back in Boston. Stahl checks back in, gets it to Peck, and he throws it right to Carl Baptiste, miscommunication.
Absolutely. Peck just didn't realize that Carl Baptiste had gone into a frontal position. Good defense by Carl down on the low block.
Saddler pulls for three. Long. Baptiste gets a hand on it, but Pollard tips it to David Walker, who pushes across half court. 5 minutes in, and Etherton going to step outside. That one off the side of the rim, tipped out of bounds. It'll go to Delaware. Scott Etherton 9 of 19 on the season. Not a terrible three-point shot, but that's not a shot maybe he should take that early in the shot clock.
You're absolutely right. Plus, they're in a bad rhythm right now offensively. He ought to be driving the ball or post him up down low so he can try to get Carl's second foul.
Delaware with the basketball now. Anderson's going to pull up deep two, and that's an air ball. He's missed not close over the past couple games. A couple air balls against UNCW as well, another today.
And Pollard definitely affected that shot with a great high hand contest.
Atherton, Walker, and Stahl working around the perimeter now. Peck another touch. He has one turnover. 17 to shoot, and Pollard's going to let it fly for three. Good over the outstretched arm of Devon Usher.
Demetrius Pollard is a terrific spot-up three-point shooter. He's also a streak shooter, so you've got to move him off the spot. You've got to force him to dribble. He lowers his percentage by about 20 points when he's off the dribble.
Saddler creating for himself as he fades away, a deep two, and the Hens up 15-6.
He's done a great job of getting Walker off balance with crossovers and step-backs.
13-51 first half. Peck in the corner. One dribble and a pass out to Pollard. Pollard around the screen, gets to the free throw line. Hesitation, pass out. And it's Etherton back on top. Nearly stolen away by Pinkert. Pollard gets it back this time on the right side. Might have got away with steps as he dragged his pivot and sends it back out to Etherton. 10 to shoot for the big man. Pollard has it back. Stall at the free throw line with 6. Challenges Baptiste. Good D by Carl. Tip back out on offensive board for Northeastern.
That was just a failure to really physically block out Etherton. He used the back tap successfully there.
Etherton sees the mismatch as Kyle Anderson was caught guarding him. He draws the foul on Anderson, second on Delaware, first on Kyle Anderson.
That was smart offense by Northeastern. They recognized that Carl Baptiste had switched off of onto Kyle Anderson's man. Anderson playing Etherton in the lane. Just a big mismatch. Might have been better to foul him on the floor.
We'll see Mo Jeffers check into the game for the first time. He'll replace Carl Baptiste, and he's continuing to get more and more minutes.
Mo is very active on the defensive end. He's long-armed. He's very physical. He's a good rebounder and has just begun to get more confident on the offensive side as well.
Stahl went over. Jeffers back to knock it out of bounds after the miss by Etherton. Lucky he didn't get called for a foul. Good position by Mo.
Absolutely. Mo did a great job of stepping his man off and held the block out as the ball went to the weak side.
Delaware up 15-7, 13-08 first half as Pinkert dribbles between his legs and gets it back to Saddler. Crossover on Saddler to the rim. What a flush over Stahl. Saddler.
Saddler rejected the screen. That means he did not use it. He drove down the lane. There was no shot blocker there at all.
Now Anderson with great D. How about the play by Devon Saddler moments ago, though? He had some room for takeoff, and Zach Stahl, better hope Mark Campbell from Headshot's not anywhere in the building, or he's going to be on a lot of the dorm room walls around this Delaware campus.
Saddler is so explosive. He's got great lower body control. He's very powerful down in his lower torso, and he does a great job of recognizing when to get to the backboard side, in that case, when to elevate over a shorter defender, and in that case, dunk the ball.
Saddler's got 6 points. There's another delay, possibly clock issues this time. They put 12:45 on, 25 seconds on the shot clock. Is Stahl the victim on defense, now on offense again. Gets it into Walker. Pollard dribbles in. Stahl over to Etherton. Head fake gets him closer, and he draws another foul as he makes the basket. Another chance for an and one. Scott Etherton, so hard to defend sometimes.
The scouting report on Etherton is stay low. He loves to use a ball fake. He's a very smart player, but as a defender, when you know that's going to happen 95% of the time, stay down, wall him off, don't allow him to get that access to the basket.
Third foul on Delaware, first on Mo Jeffers, and we'll see Flores check back in. Etherton will get a break as Chris Avenatt comes back in as well. We see Derrico Peck back to the bench.
And Reggie Spencer checking back in as well. He has been battling that hip flexor for the last three games. It's good to see him from Northeastern standpoint get back in the game.
Saddler behind the back dribble, working on Pollard. Sends it to Pinker, gets it back. 19 to shoot for Delaware, up 17-10. Now the wing right side. Saddler, crossover, pulls up. Strong around, tipped, and rebounded by Reggie Spencer. He gets over 7 rebounds per game, does Spencer, but he just dribbled it to himself and now stolen away by Usher momentarily. Flores gets it back. Missed opportunity for Delaware to steal that one away, and now Flores to the rim. He's fouled. Spencer thought a teammate was looking, threw the ball ahead, and then couldn't touch it, and Delaware had an opportunity to steal the basketball but couldn't get there in time. Delaware with a 7-point advantage, 17-10, as we take a timeout with 11:52 remaining in the first half. You're listening to 94.7 WDSD.
After a season of intense competition, only the elite are left standing.
Oh, is it loud?
The best in men's college lacrosse are coming to Newark, Delaware.
Let's it fly and score.
Experience it live at the 2014 NCAA Division I Men's Lacrosse Quarterfinals, Sunday, May 18th at Delaware Stadium in Newark, Delaware. Affordable tickets available.
Goals! And we are tied!
Visit ncaa.com/lacrosse and make a date with champions.
From day one, our mission has been March. Those 4 days in Baltimore are the reason for every rep, every sprint, every shot. Every time we step on the court, we dream of stepping on that ladder, cutting down those nets, raising that trophy. In the CAA Men's Basketball Championship, anything can happen. So turn up the music. It's time to dance.
For more information, visit caasports.com. Order tickets at ticketmaster.com.
This is Blue Hens Men's Basketball on 94.7 WDST.
Welcome back to the Value Days broadcast table presented by Exxon and Shell. We are courtside here at the Bob Carpenter Center. I want to remind our listeners that it's Value Days at participating Shell, Exxon, and Dash-Ins throughout Delaware. Today, you can save 10 cents off per gallon off of diesel, 20 cents per gallon off premium tomorrow. Then on Thursdays, 5 cents off per gallon on all grades of gasoline. Just look for the blue and red banners at participating Shell, Exxon, and Dash-In locations. Flores at the line as we get back to action, and he misses the free throw. Just a 64% free throw shooter to start.
Northeastern only shoots at 63 as a team from the foul line, so probably not a bad idea to foul Flores and send him there, but they've got to recognize who's driving and just attempt to get in his way and make him shoot the shot over taller people.
First foul on Pinkert as went to break. Flores missed both, but Spencer got the offensive board, and now he's going to be fouled. That will be the fifth against Delaware. And the second on Maurice Jeffers.
One of those little subtleties of the game of basketball is your foul shot blockout. That's something the team should practice probably a little bit more than they do. And foul shot offense, especially when the officials let you play in there a little bit more freely, you can change your alignment in the lane. You can go to the middle. You can spin. And I think the more sophisticated players have a couple of ways to attack from an offensive standpoint.
Baptiste comes back in for Jeffers, who picked up his second. Spencer makes the free throw. And Northeastern 4 of 8 today to start from the line. They're within 6, 17-11, 11:47 first half. Saddler circles the arc, brings it to the right side, posting up is Baptiste inside the paint. Gives a head fake, shot blocked by Etherton for the second time today, and it's back to the Huskies.
Etherton, a good job there of timing his block. Carl needs to shot fake and then attack right away. He waited a little too long, allowed Etherton to regain himself.
Etherton picked up his dribble, gives it to Spencer. Shot over Pinkert, around and out. Pinkert trying to grab the rebound, was fouled by Reggie Spencer. That's the third on the Huskies and the first on the junior from Tuscaloosa.
As a post player, when you shoot a jump hook in the middle, you should almost never follow your shot. Generally, the defender is going to be between you and the basket, and almost always results in an over-the-back foul. Just too aggressive there by Spencer. Maybe a result of not having played in 3 games.
We see Walker back in for Northeastern. Also Hayes in the ball game for Delaware. Hayes, Pinkert, Anderson, Baptiste, and Saddler. Saddler pulls up for a deep three, missing. Rebound on the offensive glass. Pinkert sends it back out to Hayes, and a new shot clock for the Hens.
I love the decision by Pinkert there not to rush it.
Anderson, splash off the assist. Front of on Saddler from distance, heads up 9. Second assist for Devon Saddler. And now Hayes has the duty of guarding Spencer. He sends it back out to Walker. Extra pass, Etherton. Another to Pollard. Pollard inside, kick out Walker. 18 to shoot as he dribbles in. Gets Anderson in the air. Anderson, good job avoiding contact and adjusting the shot from Walker. A miss.
Walker had him with the fake up in the air. Probably should have jumped in right away. But Anderson, as you described, got slid by him and avoided the foul.
Pinkert. Baseline now for Delaware. Bumped by Spencer. And a nice job by the freshman to draw that foul. That'll be the second on Spencer and the fourth on the Huskies.
I've been more and more impressed with Devon Pinkert and the way he's allowed the game to come to him. He now never seems in a rush when he plays. He makes good decisions on passing the ball out after rebounds. And he's always ready to shoot the ball when it comes to him in rotation.
Pinkert will check out as Davon Usher will come back into the game. But a well-deserved rest by Pinkert. Anderson inside, too strong. Etherton with the rebound, but he was pushed a bit by Saddler. And that'll be the sixth foul on Delaware, first on the senior captain.
That was a set play out of bounds underneath for Kyle Anderson, who came off the double screen. Northeastern made a mistake defensively, but their help rotated quickly, went high hands, and forced Anderson into a hurried shot.
Ends up 22-11. Pollard has it on the wing for Northeastern as the Huskies work on offense. Jimmy Marshall in front of Delaware's bench picks up his dribble. Etherton turns and faces on Baptiste. Help comes, and they left Zach Stahl open. Etherton found him with the assist.
Etherton did a great job there maintaining his dribble. He drew the help, which was Kyle Anderson coming across the lane. That left Stahl wide open on the block. A nice little pass there by Etherton.
Usher with it, right elbow as the Hens back on offense. Couple ball fakes, double team comes, contact. Usher wanted the call, didn't get it, and traveled with the basketball as he fell to the floor.
That interior passing, I think, is a coaching aspect. Billy Cohen was at Boston College. They were for years with Al Skinner as the head coach and Bill Cohen as the assistant. A great interior passing team, and they ran a lot of flex back then. That's resembling of what I think Billy Cohen did at the assistant level.
Cohen's eighth season at Northeastern. Outstanding success for Northeastern. They made it to the quarters or the semis in six of the seven tournaments since Cohen has become head coach. A whistle on the drive by Pollard. And that's going to put the Huskies on the free throw line for a 1-1.
Delaware's got to do a better job of defending the perimeter and staying in front. They typically don't tilt their defensive alignment, meaning they don't send it to the baseline or to the foul line or to the middle. What they do is they try to stay in front of, but you've got to be able to defend the player's dominant hand, but never allow them to get direct access into the lane, which is what Pollard did on that one against Hayes.
And another miss for Northeastern at the line. They're 4 of 9 today at the stripe, not helping themselves, down by 7. And Usher trying to make it 10. He does so. Straight away, 3. Pull up Jay for Usher.
The defender Stahl is not nearly as quick as Usher. He's playing off of him. He sunk beneath the screen by Carl Baptiste. Usher, great recognition.
2 of 2 is Davon Usher from distance as Etherton gets it inside. Usher tips it away, out of bounds. It'll stay with Northeastern. Quick hands shown by Davon Usher on the defensive end.
Well, that was a smart play by Usher. Etherton had gotten space in the middle of the lane. He probably should have gone right up with a jump shot, but put it on the floor. Usher was very quick-handed, knocked it away.
23-13, Etherton, guarded by Baptiste. Baptiste, good D, blocks the shot, and Saddler gets the board.
And that was that vertical nature that we've talked so much about with Baptiste.
Anderson in the corner, his pass ahead from Saddler, couldn't get the shot off as Walker approached, and now Devon will run the offense from the Blue Hens logo.
Delaware is looking to push in transition. Northeastern has not been good at defending that recently.
Hayes with the basketball. He drives on Marshall. Floats one up off the backboard. Too strong. And Stahl a rebound.
I don't mind the shot there by Hayes. He tried to use the backboard, but he would have been better off jump stopping instead of floating.
Etherton thought about a 3. He's 0 for 1 today. Instead gets it to Pollard. Pollard, a little hesitation in the lane. Shoots with the left, misses, and Baptiste, a high rebound, gets it to Usher. Usher does not have numbers, but takes on the rest of the Northeastern team and right into Jimmy Marshall, but a blocking foul is called as Marshall didn't get over in time. That'll send us to a timeout. Delaware leads it 23-13 with 7:59 to go in the first here on 94.7 WDSD.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
Basketball brought to you by the Embassy Suites, Newark, Wilmington South. It's Newark's finest all-suite hotel, offering the best in hotel accommodations and amenities. It's right across the street from the Bob Carpenter Center. To book your next stay in Newark, the Embassy Suites, call 302-368-8000 or check them out at newark.embassysuites.com. Right now, Delaware up 23-13, 7:59 to go. And how about Carl Baptiste? We keyed on this matchup, Baptiste. Etherton with 7 points, but Carl Baptiste, 5 rebounds and some good interior D.
Carl's been very active with his footwork down low on offense. He's done a great job of attacking the defensive glass and securing some very tough rebounds in traffic. And I think he's done a good job on Etherton. A couple of scores, Etherton has had a switch off and not had Carl Baptiste on him. One time Anderson, another time Usher. So Delaware probably needs to, they are going to switch those screens, but that'll allow it. Etherton to have a matchup from time to time that he may be able to exploit.
Usher makes one of two at the stripe as Northeastern picked up their fifth foul, Jimmy Marshall's first when we went to break. An 11-point advantage, now a foul away from the ball as looked like Kasman Hayes was grabbing on to Demetrius Pollard away from the ball. Second on Hayes, and now the eighth on Delaware. So 1-1 for Northeastern, who has shot just 4 of 9 today at the stripe and missed one front end. Makes this front end.
Delaware's got to do a better job at defending without fouling, or at least get to the foul line more often by driving the ball or pounding it inside to Carl Baptiste to try to affect the game and get some clock stoppages, but more important, try to get Scott Etherton in foul trouble.
Pollard makes the first, a 64% free throw shooter on a team that doesn't shoot well from the line, 63% as a team. That time makes them both, and Pollard's up to 5 points.
Northeastern has relied mostly on man-to-man. Look for them to play a little bit more zone here from time to time in the waning moments of the first half.
Usher drives, hop step, and he's held on to. That's his sixth foul on Northeastern, so no free throws yet. That should be on the floor. And it will be an inbound left side of the bucket.
Scott, they've gotten into some habits here, officials, but this is a very good crew of calling some continuations. I thought that was definitely not, and this crew, as you mentioned earlier, has done a nice job maintaining control.
Baptiste deep two. We'll call it a pass to Saddler underneath, and an assist for Carl Baptiste. I'm giving it to him. Saddler caught the air ball, went right back up with it. He's got 8, and the Hens up 11 again. Well-designed pass by Carl Baptiste. Looked like he was shooting the basketball. 7:19 to go in the first half. Avenatt in the game. Doesn't get a whole lot of minutes, just about 4 per contest. But his pass to Pollard sends Pollard in the paint. And he's got 7 now for Northeastern.
Delaware is sliding through a number of the screens set by Northeastern. But the lower they set the screens, the more they're going to have to go over the top. That time Pollard read the screen perfectly, curled, got the return pass, and attacked Baptiste, who was not willing to get a foul.
Saddler at the elbow, loses his dribble, over to Anderson. Baptiste working hard for position, gets the basketball, mid-left block, spins quickly on Etherton, tries to dunk the basketball, but a foul by Etherton will send Baptiste to the line. That's number two on, no, check that, number one on Etherton. That's the first foul on Scott Etherton, 7 on the team.
That was a great pass by Kyle Anderson to the, what we call the space post position, out about 8 feet on the baseline, and Carl, on the catch, spun immediately to his right shoulder and got by Etherton, which created the foul, or he would have had a dunk.
Baptiste, 1-1, misses the front end, and Etherton, a rebound, his fifth.
Carl's foul shot has been getting a little too high, I think, from time to time. He probably wants to bring down the trajectory slightly.
Free throw percentage has been going down over the past couple of games. Now it's 68%. Still a good free throw shooter, but you're right. I agree with you, Bill, on that one. 15 to shoot for the Huskies. Avenatt inside to Stahl. hooks it around to Etherton. That's good ball movement. Good big-to-big passing that time.
And that's what we talked about earlier. The scheme of Northeastern is to get the ball down low. They have playing behind. Delaware's playing behind. A nice little interior pass on the move as Baptiste came across to clamp on Stahl.
26-19, Saddler, a turnover as he tried to feed Baptiste. Now Stahl without numbers to the rim. Shot blocked from behind by Devon Saddler. What a defensive play. Now he pushes ahead. Anderson can't grip it, and a turnover. He had a lob ready for Davon Usher. It might have taken his eye off the basketball.
I think that's exactly what happened. Very important when the ball is slightly away from you that you get your other hand in. We call it second hand in. Go and grab the ball and clamp it before you do any hang possession. In this case, is worth at least a point.
26-19. Delaware's led by as many as 11. And now it's Pollard. Squares, fires, strong. And Pinkard gets an easy rebound as Pollard didn't follow his shot. Saddler inside of Baptiste, who ran the floor, turns and hits Carl Baptiste. So impressive.
And again, the willingness by Devon Saddler to dump the ball into him, or he might have settled for a shot or pulling it out. Baptiste running the floor because he's athletic. Etherton a little slow getting back.
There are two seniors clicking right now on the floor. Another assist for Saddler as he D's up. Stahl. Good interior move, but can't finish with it. Baptiste to rebound. Slapped away by Stahl. And a foul against Northeastern will send Carl up the line for a 1-1.
Carl was very fortunate there, though. When you get a rebound underneath, you need to chin that ball and get your elbows out. That time he kind of what we call turtled it. He dropped over top of it, allowed Stahl to reach in. I think it was the right call, but technically, Carl wants to get that ball, especially he's 6'9". His frame is so big, he can protect it at all times.
Carl, after that rebound, well on his way to another double-double as he had against Northeastern up in Boston. 7 points for Carl Baptiste, 6 rebounds. And the front end of the 1-1 on the way. Makes it that time.
I like the ball leaving his hand there. It looked like it was a little bit lower in terms of its trajectory. Carl at the defensive end, I think, has been rebounding very well because he's willing to move out of his area to go get rebounds that are maybe 5-6 feet away from him. That's where his improvement's been at the defensive end on rebounding.
Misses the second, and he'll stay in for a bit more as Barnett Harris is ready to check in for the big man at the next whistle. 5:04 first half, ends up 10. Walker has it. He's not done much today. No points, 0-1 from the field. 2 rebounds. Etherton taking it to Baptiste. Help from Usher knocks it away. Avenatt, extra pass to Walker. And on cue, Walker's first points, this time from long range.
Well, Walker is an excellent spot-up shooter, but only from the spot. He's not good off the dribble. He doesn't do the step back move. Delaware has to be there and close him out, force Walker to put the ball on the floor.
35th three-pointer of the season for Walker. Makes it a 29-22 Delaware lead. 4.5 to go first half as Usher gets it. Guarded by Stahl. Trying to set him up for a three as he stepped back but couldn't get it off. 17 to shoot for Saddler. Beyond the arc, right side. Pulls up for a three. Saddler's in double digits with 11.
Saddler loves to give his defenders that crossover, but what he's really doing is creating space, and that time horizontal space allowed him to get the shot off.
Under 4 to go first half. Ends up 10, 32-22. Etherton baseline on Baptiste. Drives past Carl and slams it with 2. Got Baptiste off his feet.
The scouting report is stay rooted against his shot fakes and ball fakes. Stay down. That time Carl left his feet, got up on his tiptoes. Immediately, Etherton recognized it and went by him.
Saddler in the corner. Anderson, quick release for Kyle. Strong and rebounded by Avenatt for Northeastern. What a patient move by Etherton last time down the floor.
Well, it's important that Carl continues to play him aggressively. Don't leave your feet and don't get a foul.
Now Etherton for 3. Short tip by Usher in the hands of Saddler. He wants to run. Does not have numbers. Will slow up momentarily. Pulls up for a tray ball. And off the side of the rim, no to Etherton.
Northeastern's done a nice job of backtracking and rebounding well in transition. Something they haven't done early in the season. Requires you to find people and block them out.
Walker squares up and hits the 3, and a nice run by Northeastern makes it a 5-point game, 32-27 after what is now a 5-0 run.
That time Walker used the high ball screen, saddled the defender, sunk underneath it. He stepped back and made the shot. They haven't been doing a lot of that. Look for Delaware to change the defense on that type of play.
2:43, first half. Quick dribbling by Saddler. He gets it to Pinkard and now gets it back to Saddler. 13 to shoot for Usher. Step back triple, and he's fouled. Usher, there's no stat on it, but he's got to lead the league in getting fouled on three-point attempts. He'll have three tries from the line when we come back. 2:35 to play. First half, Delaware leads at 32-27 over Northeastern. Hens look to make it 11 wins in a row.
Join the Delaware women's basketball team at the Bob for their annual Dare to Be Strong Women's Health Awareness Game on Sunday, February 16th at 2 p.m. In recognition of the importance of preventative care and awareness of the health issues facing the women we love today, the Blue Hens are inviting our heroic women who have shown unparalleled bravery and strength while personally battling illness to register online before Friday, February 7th to participate in the halftime parade of survivors. Those who do will receive a free game ticket for their participation. On game day, wear pink, come early, and participate in the free health screenings for women and interactive health exhibits on the concourse during pregame. Then, stay after for postgame autographs with the entire women's basketball team in the main lobby. Visit BlueHens.com to purchase tickets for as low as $5 and full event details. Delaware basketball, Blue Hens state of mind.
Is Blue Hens men's basketball on 94.7 WDSD.
Hens up 32-27 over Northeastern. Let's get you a Glasgow Medical 8-unit scoreboard update brought to you by Glasgow Medical 8-unit, servicing the local community for over 20 years for non-life-threatening injuries. Go to Glasgow Medical 8-units in Glasgow, Christiana, and Middletown. Visit them online at glasgowmedicalcenter.com. And only one out-of-town score in the CAA as Drexel leads it 27-24 over UNCW, close to the half there. And again, UNCW fighting hard against a very tough CAA opponent this time in Drexel up in Philly.
Buzz Peterson does a great job, as does Bruiser Flynn, and that's exactly how I thought that game score-wise was going to be played, probably in the mid-50s ultimately.
Usher makes the first free throw. Want to thank Joe Dombrowski from Brandywine Electronics at BEL.com. He was in here earlier tinkering with our equipment. We've got a new crowd mic. Everything sounds so clear thanks to Brandywine Electronics. And congratulations as he helped the Polar Bear Plunge raise $725,000 over the weekend, a new record for the Polar Bear Plunge as he provided audio, making everything sound so good down there and for us on 94.7 WDSD. Back in action as Usher makes all three free throws. 35-27 is the Hens lead over Northeastern. Huskies with the basketball. Atherton on the left block. Spins on Baptiste that time. An offensive foul. He hooked him. The second on Atherton.
This is a terrific officiating crew. Two from the ACC and one from the Atlantic 10. And I really think they've done a good job of watching the things that affect the game. That time Atherton definitely hooked him with his right hand as he was trying the quick spin that Carl had used against him at the other end.
2:05 remaining first half. That's the 10th foul on the Huskies. Second on Atherton. Saddler has it to Anderson off the curl, fires away, bang! Kyle Anderson, so smooth, his second three.
Delaware reversing the court twice on that possession. Anderson using a flare screen, but read it more as a flex screen, came across. A great quick release and terrific concentration as Walker was tracking him hard from behind.
38-27, matching Delaware's largest lead of the night. Atherton at the free throw line, right side. Baptiste giving him some space. Bumps him, good D again by Carl as the layup is missed and almost thrown away by Avenatti.
Carl again, slow down on the rebound, did a great job of challenging.
Anderson lights out from the corner as he had black jerseys draped all over him. His third three, Anderson has 9 of Delaware's 41, a timeout taken by Bill Cohen.
Anderson spotting up at one of his favorite spots. He loves both deep corners, that time on the left-hand side. Delaware pushed after the rebound, and that's how they want to attack Northeastern. Pretty good at their set defense. They get him early. Anderson now getting in rhythm and looks much more comfortable. Probably got a lot of shots up in the last day, even on their day off, which he definitely likes to do, and he feels and looks like he's in a terrific rhythm.
Multiple three-pointers made for Kyle for the 55th time in his career. He now has 68 on the season. Had not been shooting very well in CAA play from long range. Not the case today, as he is 3 of 4. Off the timeout, Walker, pass stolen away by Harris, now on the floor. Anderson diving for it, ball loose. Marshall comes away with it for Northeastern, now stripped by Usher, and Saddler with the steal. Ahead to Anderson. Anderson lays it up. Hard contact, no foul. The 6 assists for Saddler, and Anderson's in double figures with 11 now.
Great activity on the defensive end by Delaware. Almost every player got a little piece of the ball at some point there. Terrific pass by Saddler to it on rushing Anderson down the court.
Now a steal by Usher ahead of the pack. He goes, rise up, big fella! Usher with the lefty throwdown, and the Hens up 45-27.
Doing it with aggressive defense and the carelessness from Northeastern's part handling the basketball, which has been a weakness of theirs all season long.
11 points off turnovers now for Delaware. And with 15 seconds left in the first half, Northeastern trying to take some momentum into the locker room. A teardrop from Walker. He gets it to go. And Monte Ross can't take a timeout in the locker room. He'll draw something up with 4.3. I think they should put a little bit more time on the clock. End of this half, though, by the Hens.
I think if they look at it, Scott will have about 6.2, I believe. But you're absolutely right. The defense to offense igniting us. Two great plays, looking down the court and attacking. I love the fact that also Delaware was able to get Barnett Harris in and get Carl Baptiste out, who's going to end up only having one foul here in the first half. And I think that's really critical down the road to guarding the very fine post player of Northeastern, Scott Etherington.
And he picked that up fairly early in the contest, that first foul. 5.5 they put back on. The officials looking for the official score to see how much time it will be. And staff asking the officials if they can still run the baseline. All these things go on during a timeout that maybe some fans don't realize, that a lot of coaches not only drawing up plays, but figuring out what play they can draw up. And 5.5, the way Delaware gets down the floor, that's a lot of time.
That's 4, maybe even 5 dribbles and a shot. Should have no problem. And I'm going to guess that Northeastern picks him up in some sort of full court fashion. They don't have a big to put on the ball. So Delaware can throw it to midcourt. They can throw it all the way down. I think you'll see it entered here to Saddler on a swoop move, coming hard from right to left so he can immediately get the ball in his right hand and then dribble up the court. Northeastern probably has not practiced against this, especially with only one day of prep, but this is something when you have an opportunity to look at from a coaching standpoint of how teams handle the last 5 to 6 seconds of a game, or certainly in this case, a half.
Usher, Saddler, Pinkard, Anderson, Baptiste on the floor. Hens will inbound underneath the Northeastern basket. Don't go anywhere after these 5.8 now seconds expire. We'll have the Blue Hens halftime report with Andrew Robertson back in the WDSD studio with scores for around college basketball and news in the world of Delaware athletics. Usher can run the baseline. He'll inbound to Saddler in the backcourt. Half court is now with 3 seconds. 2 seconds for Saddler. One as he spins, forces one up, and he sinks it! Delaware goes into the locker room up 48-29 thanks to the magic of Devon Saddler.
Wow, he did get his 4 dribbles. He picked it up. I think he had an opportunity to pass the ball across to Usher, but the defense took that away. He turned and spun and then released the shot at the perfect time. That is going to be ruled good.
Phil Martelli gave us, on his way to locker room, a Michael Jordan versus the Blazers shoulder shrug. When it's going, it's going. Delaware up 48-29. Don't you go anywhere. We've got the Blue Hens halftime report with Andrew Robertson. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the newly renovated Delaware Fieldhouse, and welcome to Blue Hens Beat. I'm Scott Klatskin.
And I'm Jimmy Smith. The new turf surface here in the Fieldhouse allows teams like softball behind us to practice when it's cold like it is outside right now. Coming up in today's show, Scott will have the sports update, and you'll hear Coach Tina Martin from the women's basketball team like you never have before. We mic'd her up.
We'll also preview the upcoming men's lacrosse season when we hear from the team captains James Connolly and Garrett Johnson and head coach Bob Schillinglaw. But first, the Hens cheerleading squad represented well last weekend in Orlando during the UCA Nationals, winning the program's second national championship. Here to talk about it is head coach Ben Schreiber.
2008 and 2009, I was a member of the team competing at Nationals as a graduate student. We were very close to winning the national championship, being in second place but only a few points. 2010 was the first year I was the head coach of the program. And since 2010, 2010, 11, 12, and 13, we've been second place. 2011 through 13, each one of those years, the margin between first and second got smaller and smaller and smaller. And then finally, here we are, 2014, and we were crowned national champions. It was very exciting to see kids grow from their freshman year to the senior year, and I'm excited even this year. This is my second graduating class to finally have a senior to win a national championship. This year was definitely a special year, and we really found that out in the middle of December. When all the students leave after finals, that's when we really gear up our national season. But what really stood out this year was the closeness of every single member of this team. And that's kind of a cliche thing. Everyone says we're family, you know, we're a close team, but of all the teams I've ever coached or been a part of, something was special about this team. It's really hard to explain, it's hard to describe. Just being around it, you could sense that. And it truly was a family. During awards, they announced the top five, and when they called Wichita State in third, I knew once again it was going to be between us and Morehead State. So many years, 7 years since I've been a cheerleader and now a coach, we've heard University of Delaware second place. And after the seemed like the longest pause ever, when I heard that first syllable of Morehead State University, we finally knew we had accomplished our dream.
And in second place, Morehead.
Woo!
Oh my God!
Stephanie's crying. Look at her. Right.
I was standing just off stage, just out of the, you know, ESPN shot, and the team was going ecstatic. It's a surreal experience. When they did finally announce University of Delaware, the kids, you know, started jumping up and down. We immediately kind of rushed them, and it was just a very special time. The co-ed team is going to be off until the beginning of spring semester. The way winter session works, the ones that are not taking a class have about a 3-week break, which is due for them. They really have not had any time off since the end of July, early August. They truly have a long season, so it's good for them to kind of get a small break, really enjoy this. When they come back for spring semester, we are really going to kind of kick it back into drive, you know, finishing up basketball season and already starting to work for next year. Our all-girl team actually is coming back to campus this weekend to start competing in stunt, so we're going to be practicing with them and getting them geared for their competition season. Stunt is an emerging sport with the NCAA. It takes away the actual crowd leading factor in cheerleading and just kind of combines all of the athletic skills. Teams compete against each other in a head-to-head matchup that are actually called games, and they're actually performing compulsory skills at the exact same time, similar to a gymnastics meet. This will be Delaware's second year involved in stunt. We're hosting a game and actually a rather large tournament later in February. Well, the goal obviously now is to repeat, and it is going to take a lot of work to do that. The kids now believe that it's possible. It's been so hard being in second place so many times because after a while that starts to kind of defeat you mentally. But now that they see it's possible, I hope that they're even more driven to succeed in the future. They know it's going to take a lot of work to get back to where we want to be, but again, that they believe now is a very exciting part. For stunt, we're excited this year to be hosting a big tournament, having 6 other schools in the region coming down here. So we are looking forward to continuing that to grow. As other schools in the region develop stunt, we think that's going to kind of help with recruiting for that as well.
Welcome back to the show. Still in the newly renovated Fieldhouse, actually the place that Delaware men's and women's basketball used to call their home. Speaking of basketball, if you remember back to last show, we mic'd up head men's basketball coach Monte Ross on the sideline during the win over Hofstra. Well, we tried it again, hoping to have the same luck, this time with women's basketball. Now, you know she is an animated coach, but what in the world is she saying? Well, here's your chance to listen in to Tina Martin, mic'd up.
Here we go. Delaware on 3. 1, 2, 3.
Delaware.
Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Can we get a go, Blue Hens? How much heart do we have? How much character do we have? Are we stepping on the floor and battle them? Now let's go. KB, watch the middle. Straight up. Straight up. Dead, dead, dead. That ball's dead. I thought she had all ball, sir. It doesn't matter if you have all ball.
Ball, you hit head. No, I can't go with that.
KB, look up the sideline. That's not all for her. What is that? What is that? Can we remember? Oh, Lord, it's going to be one of those days. I hope not. But... stop ball. That's a walk. Kima, come on, go get Courtney. Come on, Kima, let's go, baby. Let's go. Let's go. Hey, you got to be more active on the boards, KB, okay? You're doing a lot of standing and jumping. Put a body on somebody and go pursue the ball, please. Trap it, let's go, grab it, grab it.
Good job.
Come on, let's go, good job, boy, let's go. Oh, that's a walk! Wow, let's go, let's go, that's a foul! Make a call! Come on, Eric, Eric. That was a walk. Is that a good screen, KB, and shape up. Come on, KB, shape up. Rebound, rebound, there you go. Come on, we got to finish that. Oh, stop ball, stop ball. Hey, we got up over here. That's you, Hannah. That's a walk. Let's go, let's go. Porter had the foul. There you go, there you go, there you go. Good job, Shanice Johnson. Nice job. Court, come here, Court. That's a good shot for you. Keep your feet set. Keep your feet set, okay? Make sure we have ball pressure at the top. That's us. That's us. Ah. Come on, Court. Make a good read. Good pass. Finish that. Yes, yes. Yes, White. Yes, White. Way to run the floor. Hey, guys, we got to rip it down. We can't be tipping it all over the place. Yes, thank you, Courtney Green. Thank you for listening. She walked! No, come on! She was backing up! Hey, hey, she was backing up the whole time! She walked! Sir, I got a question. Was that not a walk, though? Because she did walk on the spin move, I'm just saying. Well, I saw it, she made a spin move. I want to know if the walk was before or after.
I didn't see it.
Okay, all right, well, that was a walk. Yes, Shanice, you're in! And one, finish that! Rebound, Hannah! You got a rebound! Hannah, I need you on the board, you understand? Rebound! G! Drive the ball! Defense! Defense! That's a foul! And one! Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Come on, KB, put this in, please. Yes, KB, yes! Oh! Come on! Come on! What? What is that? Hey, box out, 1-1, box out, box out. Hey, hey, come here. Play good D, move your feet, no stupid fouls. Although you make me crazy when you shoot 20 footers and I tell you to go to the bed. Could they card you tonight? No, they couldn't. But that's all right, I love you anyway. Okay. Way to bounce back, guys. Way to bounce back. Here we go, Joy.
UD Hoop Squad on three. 1, 2, 3.
UD Hoop Squad. And that's a wrap, Blue Hen Nation. We got the win. We got the bounce back game. Thank you.
Yes, men's lacrosse did have a tough 2013. They lost 6 1 goal games, one in the final moments, and one in overtime. But 2014 will be a bounce back year for the young team, who was picked 6th in the preseason CAA rankings. So without further ado, here's a look at the upcoming season.
Well, last season was tough. We lost 5 games by 1 goal, and a couple of them were in overtime. So as a team, it was kind of just like a little, it was a tough thing to get through.
I was out for most of the season. I tried to come back for a couple of games, and just really wasn't working out. So I wound up sitting out for the rest of the year. And you know, it was tough, you know, seeing our team lose those close games and, you know, thinking about maybe if I was been able to contribute. It is what it is, and I'm just looking forward to this season now.
James Connolly is a hard worker, brings his lunch pail every day. Garrett Johnson, the players just respect you know, to the highest degree. Great athlete. Both have great personalities. So far, it's been great.
This opportunity that we're all given as a team is, you know, something really special. And, you know, it can be taken away from you, you know, in the blink of an eye. And I unfortunately had to experience that last year, you know, having to sit out. But, you know, I think that motivation and drive is what's going to help me out through this year.
We've been very, very pleased and excited about how the midfield units have been playing. Our first midfield unit with Brian Cormody, Steve DeLarge, who's a redshirt freshman, but, you know, really at points last year prior to his injury, looked great. Connor McRoy, a four-year player. Those three guys, not only are they good players, but they're playing extremely well together. And then that second midfield unit, we actually moved Jeff Heath from a short stick D middie to an offensive midfielder, and he's doing great. A great dodger, great cutter, good scorer. Tom Holland's really coming along. He's a redshirt junior, but he's been with the program for four seasons. Really hard outside shot. Alex Martinelli started as a freshman last year on that same second midfield line. So we really bring a lot of guys back, all in the same position. We've got some good depth, so that's a strength of our program as well. Our defense is extremely strong. We bring back the majority of the players, you know, starting with Brandon Worrell and Tripp Ashley and James Conley. You know, John O'Connor, sophomore, played all last year, great experience. Elijah Conte comes back with a tremendous amount of experience. We got two freshmen that our whole coaching staff is just in love with. I mean, Jackson Finnegan is going to see a lot of playing time. He could play offensive midi. He's going to play defensive midi for us. Phil Pinion is another freshman, but they're kind of freshmen that are playing like they're sophomores. You know, Connor Peaks stepped in for Chris Herbert last year when Chris got hurt. Outstanding athlete. I thought he had a great freshman season, you know, learning what Division I lacrosse is all about. But Chris Herbert is here, healthy again. So right now Peaks is the lead dog, but, you know, it's almost like a football program. A quarterback, you got to, you know, both guys have to be, you know, 1A, 1B. We're very, very solid in the defensive end of it. Our pulls are good. So we've got some good depth there. We're going to play numbers, and definitely that's our strength.
I pride myself in going out there and not letting the other person have a point, let alone a goal. So I really am hard on myself when it comes to that, and we think we could be one of the best defenses in the country, let alone the CAA. And we just have to focus and get the job done.
This is a challenge for us. It's a respect type thing. We're focusing less on rankings and more on getting better daily. I'm fine with being the underdog, and the program's always been kind of assumed that role. And even when we went to the Final Four, I made a comment that UD stands for underdog. So we're going to prove that you know, all the coaches were wrong in how they rated us.
Why can't we be the best team in the CAA? And what things do we need to change from last year and put that in the past to be number one?
You know, our goal is every year, you know, to get a home seed in the conference playoffs, win the conference championship, get to the NCAA tournament, and let it fly at that point. So that's our goal. Top of the list is being able to play in Delaware Stadium in the quarterfinals. So couldn't come better year. We're really excited, and team's working hard for it.
You know, we're expecting nothing less than a CAA. And, you know, we're always trying to get back to that Final Four like we did in 2007. And I think that's something that we always strive for as a team. You know, we always have these goals that we start at the beginning of the year. And obviously the first one is to, you know, get to the CAA playoffs.
Why not go back to when Garrett and I were freshmen, sophomores, when we were in NCAA tournament? We lost by one goal to Duke and UNC. So this year would be great to be able to play here and get a win for the first time.
And lacrosse starts this Saturday for the season and home opener against High Point at 1 o'clock. It's hard to believe that spring sports are actually here, but they are. That's going to do it for this edition of Blue Hens Beat. For Jimmy Smith, I'm Scott Klatskin, and as always, go Hens!
Most impressive, Scott, the fact that Delaware has 48 first half points. Very efficient. They've converted at the offensive end on fast breaks with 11 fast break points to none for Northeastern, who was trying to convert that. And we talked about that was one of the keys. Northeastern a little slow getting back.
Start of the second half brought to you by John Yasek and Andre Hoschel at Pullen and Sullivan Insurance, helping guide families and small businesses through health care reform. For more info, visit Pullen-Sullivan.com. Northeastern will get the basketball first. Delaware goes with their starters to start the second half. Saddler, Usher, Pinkard, Baptiste, and Kyle Anderson. For Northeastern, Etherton, Stahl, Walker, Pollard, and Flores. 22 to shoot as they go inside to Etherton, working on Carl Baptiste. Fakes right, shoots with the left, and scores on the first possession.
Well, I think we'll see a lot of low post touches by Scott Etherton. Coach Cheeks mentioned how Delaware's got to force him to post up a little further away from the basket and also look for some helpers to come in, especially off the pass.
Saddler for three. It is his night here in Newark. He's got 17.
Devon Saddler is doing a great job of reading the way the defense is playing these flare screens up top. That time they trailed. He curled wide open for the three-point look.
Flores, Walker, a head fake on the three. 18 to shoot. A minute into this first, the second half of action. As Pollard into Etherton. 9 to shoot for Etherton. He'll pull up the jumper off the rim, and Pinkard with a rebound.
That time, Carl Baptiste did a great job of staying low, challenging late, not allowing Etherton to shot fake him or put the ball on the floor into the lane.
Pinkard puts on the floor, floats one up. Couldn't get the soft touch to go, but Baptiste is there. No one boxed him out.
Baptiste in perfect position on the weak side, got the ball right away, kept it high, and finished before Etherton could recover.
Four players in double digits now for Delaware. Baptiste gets to the 10-point mark. And the Hens up 53-31. Stahl on the right block. Pinkard guards him. Stahl loses grip. Another steal for Delaware. Saddler ahead. It's Anderson to the rim. He goes soaring and scoring. Kyle Anderson has 13.
Delaware continues to exploit Northeastern. Slow get back in transition. That time they had two players down in a pile. Stahl and Walker, neither of them could even get to half court before the score.
13 points off turnovers now for Delaware as we get the first foul of the second half. It goes against Delaware, and Kyle Anderson, I believe, was called for the hold. That's his second.
Coach Cohen going to his bench here quickly with both Peck and Spencer coming back in. Spencer played limited minutes in the first half. He's coming off the hip flexor injury. They need him in there to be that other low post threat to allow them not to double Etherton so easily.
Pollard sees a lane, floats one up from 5 feet. Short for Kyle Anderson, who's averaging 4 rebounds per game this season for Delaware. Saddler between the leg, passed as he drops it off to Usher. Usher over to Baptiste, guarded by Etherton, hand to the face over to Anderson. Anderson gets to Baptiste to repost, turns baseline. The reverse is not there. Etherton got a hand on it off the body of Baptiste and out of bounds.
Carl tried to use a reverse Mikan where he dribbles along the baseline and then tries to use the basket, the rim, as a shot block protector. But unfortunately, Spencer, who's entered the game at 6'7", was there to block a shot actually off of Carl's hand.
10th block of the season for Reggie Spencer. Spencer played in 83 consecutive games before missing the last three for Northeastern, an Ironman for the Huskies squad. 55-31, Delaware leads it inside to Spencer. Working on Pinkard from the right block, too strong off the window. And Baptiste amongst the black jerseys gets the rebound, his ninth. Pinkard, Usher, couldn't get the three off, and back to Saddler it goes.
I like that. I think Usher could have shot the ball, but he decided not to. They pull it out, they're going to run a little clock, make Northeastern defend them.
Pinkard to Anderson. Anderson along the arc, left side. Saddler inside, leads it for Carl. Power dribble to the rim, and a help D by Spencer again. Another block. Gives it back to Northeastern. Pollard over to Walker, wide open for a three. Made his first two, can't connect that time. Etherton knocks it out of bounds. It goes to Delaware.
Well, Delaware fortunate there. They were a little slow getting back. They tried to bother the ball as it went up. You're better off getting back defending, especially because Northeastern does a good job in transition of spotting up with spacing.
Devon Saddler will walk the ball up the floor. His team up 24 points. End of the first half so well. Off to a good start here in the second. Calling for it is Saddler as they worked it around the arc. Anderson working hard off the basketball to get open. His pass to Baptiste. And a jumper from Carl Baptiste. Showing the range. It's good.
That was great offense in the fact they reversed the floor twice and four players touched the ball before a wide open mid-range shot by Baptiste at the foul line.
Etherton now spins into a double team. Shot over his head. He draws contact and the foul. Etherton will shoot two when we come back. Delaware leads it 57-31 over the Northeastern Huskies, 15-58 to play. Basketball being brought to you by Legacy Pharmacy, creating rub-ins for where it hurts. For more info, visit summitrx.com. We've been so impressed with Devon Saddler so far in so many different ways, but the 17 points, I don't know if that even stacks up with the 7 assists. He is finding teammates in new and exciting ways.
It makes him so difficult to defend is that he's a willing passer. He can get into the lane anytime he wants. He worked the offensive boards, as we saw in that air ball pass that you described so well from Carl Baptiste. But what I really like is his unselfishness. He's taking a good shot almost every time down the floor, and very unusual for your team's leading scorer, who may from time to time have to take some forced shots due to the shot clock.
And even when he asked the fourth one at the end of the first half, he drilled it from deep at a tough angle. Etherton makes the first free throws. We get back into action. Second foul on Delaware sent us to break. Misses a second, tapped out by Spencer, but into the hands of Kyle Anderson.
Delaware continues to impress me with all five players blocking out and rebounding on the defensive end.
Usher to Anderson, square, fire, short, and rebound by Peck for Northeastern.
That time Northeastern fell back into their 3-2 zone. That afforded them a little bit of time to wall off Anderson out at the three-point line.
Walker misses the runner, put back there for Spencer. That's not Walker's game off the dribble, but Spencer a good cleanup.
And Spencer, with his length, is pretty adept at working to the weak side. That has not been a big factor here. That was only their fourth offensive rebound. Delaware has done a good job of maintaining their defensive glass presence.
Pinker leaves his feet, finds Anderson, though. Hens up 57-34. 15 to shoot for Usher. Now Saddler in front of the Delaware bench, guarded by Walker. Brings it back out between the circles. Peck defends with 7. Saddler for 3. Strong, and Pinkard tracks down the rebound. Saves it into the hands of Peck, though. A turnover. Going the other way for Northeastern. Walker lays it up and through. Good transition basket. And the first points off a turnover for the Huskies.
And that's why, as a player, you never want to save the ball to anyone other than your own teammate.
Baptiste. Corner is Anderson, driving the lane now and off the window and through. Anderson attacking.
I love that attack, especially considering he finished over Spencer, who was set up, and he did a great job of working his body to the right angle where he did not pick up an offensive foul.
Kyle Anderson's got 15. He had not reached double figures in 6 of the last 7, but having a great game today. Inside Etherton, he's got good position, pushes off Baptiste. They're to call Carl for the foul as Etherton is 3rd time tonight he's gotten an and-one opportunity.
That was a low block screen play for Etherton. Etherton went underneath, and typically when that happens, there might be a switch because Carl went over the top, Etherton went underneath, that created the separation, and then Carl, as he tried to react to get inside, back inside, he just hit him on the hip, and that was kind of a senseless foul, and that'll cause him to come out.
Free throw good from Etherton, makes it 59-39. Third foul, as you mentioned, to Baptiste. He'll check out. Into the game is Mo Jeffers. He joins Anderson, Usher, Saddler, and Pinker. Saddler lobs at the corner to Usher. Left side, baseline. He dribbles out, passes to Saddler with 15 to shoot. Saddler, a pass to Anderson. Anderson, baseline drive, kick out. Usher open for 3. The lefty drains it.
great ball movement and great player movement as Anderson chose to drive along the baseline. He got caught up in the air, but he found Usher wide open on the left side. Foul line extended for the three.
Hens shooting 63% from long range, 52% from the field. 17 to shoot for Etherton. Deep on the right wing. Peck gives it to him underneath. Draws a double team. Usher nearly takes it away from him. Ball is stripped and off of Usher. It'll stay with Northeastern as it goes out of bounds. Right sideline. 9 to shoot off the inbound.
A great dig technique by Devon Usher as he came off the passer. He went inside right exactly where the ball was with Etherton. Grabbed it almost a tie-up.
Lob to Spencer. And he finishes around the rim. Good pass by Pollard as they went back door a bit.
There was no ball pressure there, and Spencer was left unaccounted for on the weak side, and a nice pass by Pollard.
Saddler splits D, and Pollard, all he can do is reach in to slow him as he gets across half court. That's the first foul on the Huskies this half. The reach-in is the second. Demetrius Pollard, the junior from Virginia Beach.
I think we'll continue to see Northeastern in their zone. They're just trying to do anything they can to slow down Delaware here in transition as well as in their half-court attack.
Usher to Saddler, top key, draws the double. Over to Usher, corner is Pinker, dribbles out, hands it back to Usher. Usher, now it's Anderson, left corner. An air ball strong, into the hands of Devon Usher. He'll reset as the shot clock doesn't. Still 16 to shoot though.
Great decision by Usher with two shot blockers around him to bring the ball out to the top for Saddler to attack.
Saddler does just that. Floats it up and in. He's got 19, a basket away from the all-time record.
Great body control and also a great feel for where to release the ball with the shot blocker coming to him.
Corner is Peck for Northeastern. To Etherton, extended elbow left side on top to Pollard. Peck, extra pass to Walker. Deller leads it 64-41. Peck inside to Etherton and a whistle as Jeffers and he were fighting for position. And that's the third on Mo Jeffers.
Northeastern very intelligent here in their attack in the second half, getting the ball to Etherton almost every possession down on the low block. They want him to either get fouled or score in close, so they get a lot of stoppages and a lot more possessions here in the second half.
Walker gets the jump shot for Northeastern, makes it a 64-43 basketball game. 12:02, second half, as Saddler goes top of the key, brings it back out with 23 to shoot. Pass to the corner, Usher wide open, can't do that. Another one for Devon Usher. He's 4 of 4 from long range.
The 3-2 zone is very good at handling anything above the foul line, but that time Saddler recognized Usher wide open on the baseline. That's too long a closeout by the bigs, Spencer and or Etherton on the baseline.
It's 67-43 as t-shirts fly thanks to First State Orthopedics after that three-pointer by Usher. On the other end, another foul for Jeffers. That's his fourth, and Etherton will shoot more free throws. He's 5 of 7 today. Hens up 67-43, 11:27 to go. Don't go anywhere as Devon Saddler's 2 points away from the all-time mark.
After a season of intense competition, only the elite are left standing.
Oh, wow!
The best in men's college lacrosse are coming to Newark, Delaware.
Let's it fly and score!
Experience it live at the 2014 NCAA Division I Men's Lacrosse Quarterfinals, Sunday, May 18th at Delaware Stadium in Newark, Delaware. Affordable tickets available.
And we are tied!
Visit ncaa.com/lacrosse and make a date with champions.
From day one, our mission has been March. Those 4 days in Baltimore are the reason for every rep, every sprint, every shot. Every time we step on the court, we dream of stepping on that ladder, cutting down those nets, raising that trophy. In the CAA Men's Basketball Championship, anything can happen. So turn up the music. It's time to dance.
For more information, visit caasports.com. Order tickets at ticketmaster.com.
Men's basketball on 94.7 WDSD.
And the Hens lead at 67-43 over Northeastern. 11:27 left to play. The Hens working the ball against this Northeastern zone. 12 assists tonight.
They averaged 10.5 in conference play. And though I don't want to overanalyze the statistic, what it tells me that they've assisted on half the shots they've made tonight, and that is a big stat in that they're really sharing the ball, they're moving without the basketball, they're doing a good job of screening for one another and also recognizing who's open in the right spots. Delaware playing as smart a floor game offensively as I think they've played all season long.
Etherton makes the free throw. He was fouled by Jeffers, his fourth, brings Baptiste back into the game. Etherton makes them both. And 19 points for Scott Etherton, matching the game high with Devon Saddler. Saddler has 8 of those Delaware 12 assists. As Pinkert, dribble handoff to Usher. He does the same to Saddler. Saddler, guarded by Pollard, back near the center circle. Saddler gives it to Anderson. Anderson, corner to Pinkert. Pinkert sets, can't hit on the three. Baptiste, an offensive board, out to Usher. Usher will try again from three, and he's 5 of 5 from long range.
I know a lot of people talk about the greatest time to shoot a three is on an offensive rebound. I'm not always so sure that's the case, but in that case it was, because he had no defender closing him out.
Unreal. He's got 21. And now back on D, a turnover. Etherton threw it right between Stahl and Pollard. Cohen ended up catching it on his bench, a turnover.
Etherton gets a lot of touches, thus he's going to command a lot of attention inside. He does turn the ball over about 3 times a game.
Here's Saddler, pass to Baptiste on the give and go. A missed dunk, though, inside. A little strong.
That was a great pass by Saddler again. Baptiste showing his dribbling expertise there. Might have been better to fake. He had a shot blocker coming.
Ends up 70-45 against Northeastern. A good road basketball team. Not tonight, though. Delaware too much offensively. Etherton draws the double. Stahl thought about the three. Pollard will take the three after the extra pass. Around and out on a rebound for Kyle Anderson.
Delaware perfectly positioned inside. They had 4 available rebounders. Anderson continues to do a great job on the defensive glass. Very active and very willing to do that part of the defensive game.
Halfway through the second half, as Usher has it, gives it up to Saddler on the left wing. Saddler dribbles left side, draws 2, and brings it back out. 12 to shoot for Saddler. Devon, crossover, pull-up jumper, and an air ball into the hands of Baptiste. Partially tipped, I believe, by Pollard. Goes out of bounds baseline. It'll stay with Delaware.
Pollard did a terrific job there of staying in front of Devon Saddler as he tried a variety of different dribble techniques. None were working at that point. Sometimes the defense is better than the offense, even on a great player.
Baptiste with 4 to shoot off the inbound. Misses. Usher rises to tip it to himself, and Delaware has the basketball back.
What a smart play by Devon Usher. They're recognizing he couldn't quite grab it. He tipped it to himself, which was in the open court.
Here comes Saddler inside, working hard against Etherton. And Etherton with the rebound after the miss in the paint. It's Walker to Etherton. Pass into traffic, tipped out. Stahl has it on the wing. Into the paint, hop step. Good take by Stahl, couldn't finish though. Baptiste ahead to Saddler. Saddler, middle of the floor. Behind to Anderson. Anderson's 3 on the way, around and out. And a rebound by Etherton.
It was a great contest by David Walker, the sophomore from Stowe, Ohio. Anderson might have been better served there with a little shot fake and go by him, or at least let the closeout go by.
Walker, hesitation, shot blocked by Baptiste. Anderson has it now, across half court to Saddler. Saddler, extra pass, Pinkert. Pinkert, corner 3. That one's a miss. Usher, Pinkert again, second try. Around and out. That was halfway down for the rookie.
Pinkert's shot is a little flat from the corner, but he's been on target a lot recently. He's a streak shooter, but a great hustle play by Devon Usher.
Etherton will try the 3. That one's flat as well, and it's short. Usher on the run. Behind the back dribble. Into the corner. Back out to Saddler. Saddler between the circles. Hands up 70-45 as Saddler brings it over to the left side. Usher with it now. Driving on Etherton. Baseline. Contact. And somehow he gets it up and through using his offhand and off the window.
Usher did a great job there of using the slither technique where he goes left, comes back, slides back right, used his right hand. Many times he switches back. The shot blocker was there. Unbelievable creativity by Devon Usher.
And with that, Bill Cohen will call a timeout. We'll take a break with him. 7:47 remaining. Delaware up 72-45 over Northeastern.
Delaware Athletic sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year.
Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
Timeout with his team down 72-45. He's seen about all he could take. And we'll get another timeout at the next buzzer as there's 7:47 left to go. That next break will bring us to the media timeout.
Well, Coach Cohen is searching for a defense that might work. He's tried the zone, a little bit of pressure, certainly his man-to-man. The difference is that Delaware is just playing at such a high level right now offensively. They take great care of the basketball. They're looking for their teammates. They have three players, sometimes four, that can create off the dribble. They've got a big-time post player who's playing very well. And I just think, overall, very unselfish play.
Hands on D after the timeout. Pollard looking to get it inside to Etherton. Guarded by Jeffers, who has the four fouls. Can't go to him on the first try. 13 to shoot for Northeastern. Inside to the freshman, Ibaka, playing his first minutes in quite some time. And Cohen just looking for answers. But he gets the reverse layup to go through. And Delaware up 72-47. Hayes in the game. Back to Saddler. Into the corner. Hayes will bring it back out to Pinkert. 18 to shoot for Saddler. Saddler picks up his dribble, goes to Anderson. He drives baseline, cut off by Ibaka. Now 11 to shoot. Saddler between the circles. A crossover. Takes it inside, floats it up. Off the rim and out. Etherton with the rebound.
Saddler doing a great job of splitting the top of the 3-2 zone. Just missed on his floater.
Saddler stays 2 points away from passing Mike Pegues as the all-time leading scorer at Delaware. Pollard from the elbow, right side, misses. Back tap by Hayes. Pinkert on the run. Gets caught up from behind and turns it over. Now ahead to Etherton, being chased by Hayes, and Etherton lays it up and through as he got ahead of Kasman Hayes.
Pinkert ran down the long rebound, chose to dribble it down. They had more players back than Delaware had down. He'd been better off either retreat dribbling or picking the ball up.
Ends up 72-49 as Delaware certainly not in a hurry with a big lead over Northeastern. Hayes picks up his dribble looking for help. Gets it to Saddler on the right side. Ball fake into the paint. Saddler lays it up. Out. Jeffers is there.
Mo Jeffers did a great job of positioning himself on the backside of the rim as Saddler attacked on the baseline looking for the dunk. Jeffers really playing some great minutes here for Delaware in tonight's ball game.
He really,
as he did the other afternoon as well.
He's been giving Delaware great minutes. A redshirt freshman from D.C. Ibaka with a right hand. He's got four off the bench, doubling his season total in a matter of seconds.
And there's a smart substitution by the crafty veteran, Coach Cohen. He's doing a great job over there trying to get this team back in the game with some man and some zone. They're just a little overmatched tonight, especially with Delaware's efficiency from the three.
Delaware up 74-51. Saddler backing down Pollard. And basket will not count for Saddler as it was a foul on the floor, but that's just the second foul on the Huskies. It will send us to a timeout. 5:16 remaining. Delaware leads at 74-51 over Northeastern.
Join the Delaware women's basketball team at the Bob for their annual Dare to Be Strong Women's Health Awareness Game on Sunday, February 16th at 2 p.m. In recognition of the importance of preventative care and awareness of the health issues facing the women we love today, the Blue Hens are inviting our heroic women who have shown unparalleled bravery and strength while personally battling illness to register online before Friday, February 7th to participate in the halftime parade of survivors. Those who do will receive a free game ticket for their participation. On game day, wear pink, come early, and participate in the free health screenings for women and interactive health exhibits on the concourse during pregame. Then, stay after for postgame autographs with the entire women's basketball team in the main lobby. Visit BlueHens.com to purchase tickets for as low as $5 and full event details. Delaware basketball, Blue Hens state of mind.
94-7 WDST. Ends up 74-51 as we went to a timeout. Devon Saddler was grabbed before a basket went good. And some conversation between Coach Rafferty and Carl Hess, one of the officials, probably saying, my guy needs 2 points for the record. If you counted the basket, I could have taken him out with my team up 74-51.
I thought the veteran official, Carl Hess, handled that really well. He works as many games in the NCAAs as anybody. He's already done 63. He's traveled to 22 states already this year. They were trying to work him over to get that call as a continuation, but he's a little too crafty, even for Coach Rafferty.
Anderson off the inbound. Saddler, jumper, baseline. Couldn't get it there. Hayes crashes. He can't finish with the putback.
But what an athletic move there by Kasman Hayes to be so well positioned and rise up over two much taller players.
They're trying to draw something up to give Saddler a rest. Couldn't get it there. He's now 7 of 18 from the floor after a couple misses on the past several possessions. Ibaka working on Pinkert, and Ibaka draws the foul on Devon Pinkert. We see Kwesi Ibaka from North Gwinnett High School in Georgia playing just his ninth game this season, 20 minutes all year. But he's got 4 points after scoring just two total on the campaign.
He's shown some nice activity down the low block. He's tall and thin, but he's very quick-footed, and Delaware's got to do a little bit better job of defending him. Pinkert behind him there allowed Ibaka to come into the middle. He's a left-shoulder turner and a right-handed shooter.
Mo Jeffers thought he fouled out, I believe. A foul was called on Devon Pinkert. Or perhaps Mo has an injury. He's coming to the bench now as Carl Baptiste will check in before the first free throw. Ibaka makes the free throw, his first make of his young career, the redshirt freshman, medical redshirt a season ago. Second one flat and short into the hands of Carl Baptiste. Delaware leads at 74-52, 4:47 remaining in the ball game. Saddler with it. Loses grip momentarily, poked away by Pollard. Back to half court goes Saddler. A crossover. Saddler picks up his dribble. Pinkert with a three left side. That's strong. Baptiste trying to tip it to himself. He's fouled as Avenant and Ibaka both in the area. Just the third foul on the Huskies, though. And Delaware will inbound.
Carl working for his 14th rebound there. Incredibly active. I just love how aggressive he is. He's playing without getting into deep foul trouble, being very efficient inside on his scoring, and I think has done a pretty good job. Maybe not his best job of the season, but a very solid job on the defensive end against Atherton, a very clever defender.
Anderson to Saddler. He misses on the floater off the inbound. It's a career high for Carl Baptiste. 14, his previous career high, 13 against Drexel. And a miss on the other end by Ibaka. Now it's Saddler. Cross half court. High dribbles. Pollard picks him up near the three-point line. Crowd anticipating it. Saddler working to the right side. Now a crossover. Devon inside, draws contact, and he can do it from the line.
Saddler being very creative with the dribble. He can handle it as well as anybody in the conference. He can get anywhere on the court because not only of his ball handling skills, but his body. He's very explosive and very strong, can play through the first bump on almost every possession.
Saddler will shoot two. Needs both to become the all-time leading scorer at Delaware. And now the officials making sure it was a two-shot foul. It is for Saddler. Saddler at the stripe. Makes the first. He's tied Mike Pegues. Saddler has 20 points, 8 assists, 5 rebounds on 7 of 19 shooting. The Bob Carpenter Center crowd on their feet. Devon Saddler makes the free throw. And Saddler is now the most prolific scorer in Delaware basketball history, passing Mike Pegues, 2,031 points all time.
And his first embrace, the man that recruited him, Jeff Rafferty, brought him here. Coach Ross obviously eventually tied him up. But that's a very proud moment for that Delaware staff. A terrific player and just a heart of a champion.
As Ibaka makes the floater, good move inside by Ibaka. Hens up 76-54. And a smart crowd here at the Bob Carpenter Center. There was no announcement that said Saddler needs 21. They knew it. They rose to their feet and gave Saddler the ovation that he's deserved over the past four seasons playing basketball with the Hens. A nice job by this Bob Carpenter Center crowd to know the knowledge that he needed 21. Pinkard misses the three, and Pollard's on the run. He tripped up. They're going to call a foul on Anderson. I thought Pollard just lost his footing.
He did, but I think there was a bump that just occurred before. I thought Anderson very smartly was trying to retreat and let Pollard fall down.
We'll take our final timeout. 3:18 to go. Delaware's been in control this entire second half. 76-54, Delaware in the lead. From this crowd, and what a career he has had. 2,031 points now, passing one of the all-time greats, if not the all-time great at Delaware, Mike Pegues, who had 2,030 from 1996 to 2000.
To pass a player like Mike Pegues, you've really got to have done something. Obviously, a very long and storied career for Devon Saddler. I also like the fact that he gets his other teammates involved. He's a willing share of the basketball. He's just not a scorer. Very rarely do you see an all-time scorer also be such an assist man. He plays very hard defense. He fills up the stat line in many, many ways. And I think he's a very enthusiastic teammate, one that you'd always want to play with.
21 points, 8 assists, 5 rebounds. His night probably done with 3:18 left to go and a big lead here, up by 20 over Northeastern after free throws brought us back. Balanced scoring night is Usher, actually the game high in points, 23 for him, 15 for Anderson, 12 for Baptiste, who has a double-double, 12, and as we mentioned, those 14 rebounds, a career high. Anderson has it, pass back to Hayes, is stolen by Flores, Flores ahead, lays it up with the right hand.
Well, Kyle Anderson got caught up in the air that time. He was looking for Kasman Hayes to come on a little bit more of a crackback maneuver, meaning come all the way up the court behind him. That's just a little careless turnover.
Usher floats it, misses. Baptiste, another board, and the putback with the left. 15 rebounds, 14 points for Carl Baptiste.
And Delaware with their 16th offensive rebound to only 4 for Northeastern. Great activity on their offensive glass tonight.
2:30 left. Delaware up 78-58. Flores is going to try a three. Left wing, good. He's got 5 in a row for Northeastern.
Devon Usher has played an extremely efficient and almost quiet offensive game, scoring 23 points on only 10 shots, 5 rebounds and assist, and 5 for 5 from the triple. That's an incredible line, and I just like his unselfishness. 2 or 3 times tonight he probably could have scored and passed it up, especially feeling the hot hand.
I think 2.3 points per field goal attempt would got to be up there amongst the nation leaders. That's how efficient Usher has been. As he lost it out of bounds, Jimmy Marshall touched it last. Under 2 minutes to play, 10 to shoot for Delaware. This one in control. Usher, a crossover in the paint, loses grip. 6 to shoot now. He'll try a three off the side of the backboard that time. His first miss from three-point range, made his first 5. Now Marshall from a deep off the front of the rim, and Flores gets it back for Northeastern. Long rebound for the Huskies. Back door they go to Avenatt. Pass out. Marshall driving inside. Stall with contact off the window and through from the right side.
Stahl, who had a terrific game up at Northeastern 3 weeks ago, has been limited here. He had a double-double, only 6 rebounds and 4 points.
Usher, hop step inside, leans in, draws the foul, and one for Devon Usher. And we're going to see the walk-ons play the final 70 seconds.
And this is an exciting time for these young men, three of whom I know really well, coach two and coached against the other. Tommy Allshaus, Sean Locke, Dylan Miller. You'll have Tommy Davis coming in. And this is a great moment to get some playing time against the team. And I think a very nice move here by Coach Ross. And this, there's no way that Coach Cohen or his team should feel any problem with this.
And what's great about having the walk-ons come in is they play, I don't think people realize how hard they work in practice. They are the other team. They pretend to be these guys and where they'll be on the floor and try to mimic how they play throughout the week. They play hard and they deserve this. This is great to have an opportunity to get these guys on the floor. Sean Locke, Tom Allshaus, Dylan Miller, Tommy Williams in the game.
And what's really important to recognize is they do everything that the starters and 7th, 8th, and 9th men do, but just don't get much playing time. So a rare opportunity, and it's really fun for their parents who are here to watch them play.
Usher allows Stahl to go past. Delaware up 80-63. Usher will bring the ball up the floor. He'll try to set up a teammate. Usher checks the clock, dribbles back near half court.
And I think it's important that Delaware goes ahead and plays here. These walk-ons don't get much of a chance. I think Usher's trying to get the ball to Miller.
Miller gives it back to Usher. Now Locke with the basketball. Allshaus sets his former St. Mark's teammate a screen. Now 8 to shoot for Usher. Usher loses grip of it. Allshaus tips to Locke. Locke in the corner for a 3 off the mark. And the shot clock unplugged for Northeastern. He had a good look. Avenatt ahead to Marshall. He lays it up and through, and we'll have another chance for Williams, Locke, Allshaus, or Miller to get in the books.
Well, before Sean Locke had a couple of knee surgeries, he was as good an open shooter and a spot-up shooter that there was in the state. A terrific young man, a terrific student, and a family who really follows his exploits here. And it was really great to see these young men get an opportunity. I think Coach Ross should be commended for that.
Delaware wins it 80-67 over Northeastern as the final horn sounds. The Hens 9-0 in the CAA. Winners of 11 straight. We'll be back to talk about it on our American Spirit postgame show, brought to you by the American Spirit Federal Credit Union in Newark, Middletown, and Dover, and online at americanspirit.org. Delaware wins it 80-67 over the Huskies. We'll be back.
Once again, congratulations.